Without further ado, Adela Wilcox.
Good evening, and thank you. Okay, this first one is called Tidal Waves. The ebb and flow of the tides is no match for the ebb and flow of emotions in a human heart. We love and we fear, often the same things. We hurt and we forgive, or we hold on to the outcomes that were never meant to be, or we hurt each other's for not meeting our expectations. But the ebb and flow of emotion surrendered brings us back to ourselves and the one we find in the peace we are seeking in the silence of our heart's tide. And we find ourselves being the love that we were seeking outside of ourselves in the waves of love in action. This is called Inward Bound. Another time for reality to change, careful plans rearranged. Did karma finally come to bite you in the ass, or did that fear come to pass? Security turned out to be a lie, and a part of you finally died. But instead of mourning, you close your eyes, and through the noise in your head, you realize that the only answer is to go within, find the peace of knowing you're about to begin. A journey of emotion, truth, and justice. The only thing that will stop you is a lack of trust in the one that knows only love and creation. No beginning or end, no outer distraction. Past all pretense and symbolism, beyond knowledge and altruism. To the perfect silence that fills the soul, conviction that you are the whole. You open your eyes and see a new picture, beyond meaning, technology, or scripture. Finding dynamic balance in the original plan and take a step into the next phase of man. This is defined. When courage is defined by the ability to stand down and walk away, when faith is defined by the everyday acts of work, love, play, and cry, when the need to be well is more important than the need to be right, when the words are obscured by actions, when we see and listen with our hearts and move with understanding, when character is defined by how well we live instead of how much we stand out, when responsibility is taken on joyously and comfort is abandoned, when ideals are more than sound bites, when activism means humble service, and religion is defined by oneself and God alone. Coexistence will be synonymous with inner peace. And this is a relatively new one. Socialist tendencies. I am amazed by how small my world seems when I focus on what's wrong instead of what I can add to it. The realm of possibility is limited only by my fallibilities and my willingness to surrender my power to them. But when I look around and see an emerging culture with a propensity for justice and awareness, which feel right when I try them on like a perfect jacket, I feel the freedom to move about while keeping me at a constant temperature. As I wait for kindred spirits to join the circle so we can cast off our inhibitions together and take the underground to a whole new level of social consciousness and individual expression. Meanwhile, I seek out the beacons of art to find those who see the world through realization and embrace the darkness within that teaches the lesson needed for the light to shine through the strands of the web that illuminates our community. And the final one is called Grace. Nobody knows that nobody's right. Nobody knows that nobody's wrong. Nobody but Grace. Grace knows that pain is love imprisoned, speaking in mad tongues, facades of hate, and whispers of lucidity. Answering prayers of faith lost in a sea of wishes and forgotten victories. Nobody knows that nobody's rich. Nobody knows that nobody's poor. Nobody but Grace. Grace knows that wealth is perception, skewed by a race for survival in concrete jungles and nature subdued. Realized in the security of a life well lived and the surrender of love. Nobody knows that nobody really dies, because grace has no body, because grace is everyone. Thank you.